Welcome back. This is the second video of the answers of the questions about force and friction deck. We now consider a horizontal plate instead of a vertical plate. You can see the flow is now flowing more linear around the plate. It's more like this. Now you can say, so the only friction deck you can have is now here. If you look at the form rack, you see that the flow doesn't have to bend much to flow around the shape. So there's just a little bit form drag and a lot of friction drag. So let's go to the questions. If we raise the diameter of the shape, and still the diameter of the shape is much smaller than the length of the shape, the friction drag is determined by the length of the shape, so the diameter does not influence the friction drag. What if we raise the length of the shape? Then we get a situation where it's more like this. So we have a larger shape. But then there will be more friction of the flow around the shape. So we can say, if we increase the length of the shape, also the friction drag is increased. In the last question, the orientation of the plate is changed to this. If we now take a look at the friction, we can draw the friction only on this side of the plate, because the flow is going around the plate and doesn't touch really behind of the plate. So we can now say, well, then the friction drag decreases if we change the orientation of the plate to this situation. If you still have questions, you can always contact us or somebody else on the forum.